The motion was like a riding on a bus in a very rough road.
That's how a Philippine TV reporter describes the moment Tuesday's devastating earthquake hit. The 7.1 magnitude quake toppled buildings, trickled landslides, and sent thousands of panicked people into the streets.
I ran out of the office because all the glass was shattering. I was rattled with all the shaking from the earthquake, since it won't stop.
The earthquake stopped, but there was another tremor, so we rushed out. All of us tried to get away, but there was a big chunk of concrete that fell from the upper floors.
Many of those killed were hit by falling rubble. At least three were crushed to death trying to flee a crowded sports complex. Patients at one hospital were moved outside after hundreds of aftershocks left survivors on edge.
We are not the only ones who decided to let them outside. The patients themselves wanted to get out because of the earlier earthquake.
The quake was centered more than 600 kilometers south-southeast of Manila, near the city of Cebu and neighboring island of Bohol, both popular destinations for tourists. A handful of historic churches were also leveled in the disaster. Tourist Robert Michael Poole says he saw widespread damage on the island of Bohol.
I was on the coast when the earthquake happened, which seemed to be very severely struck with roads cracked, bridges down, and one of the main churches here pretty devastated. People have been pretty calm. They're obviously all out on the streets, but fortunately no real sense of panic, just sort of more confusion and shock.
Authorities are still trying to assess the damage, but many roads remain impassable and power is still out across much of the area. And with dozens of people still missing, search teams are looking for anyone still trapped in the rubble. Mari Ramos, CNN.